Welcome back to The Morning Show here on Arise News. I am Toyosi Etim Efyong. Now, African leaders say that a people without the knowledge of their past history, origin, and culture is like a tree without roots. Goes without saying that we're all to do all we can to preserve our culture, which includes our language, food, and even our structures. Kelechi Anabraonye is my first guest today, and he's a budding preservationist, collector, and a local guide in Lagos. He focuses on historic colonial architecture in Nigeria and also documents colonial structures, even as he tries to prevent them from becoming extinct. And I am so glad to be talking to you this morning, Kelechi. Welcome to The Morning Show.
Thank you very much.
So this is not a field that a lot of young people go into. I don't have any friend. I was going to say I have a few friends, but I don't even have one friend who I know is a preservationist. So going about saying, oh, this building is beautiful, don't tear down this building, or let's preserve this garden. How did you get involved and interested in such a field?
It started off, I think, 2014. I always like to tell people that, but before 2014, but like I used to be like interested in like contemporary architecture, and then from that point, I would love like futuristic buildings. But as time went on, from like 2014, because I graduated from King's College in 2013, and then I was always sort of like unconscious of the fact that. This building that I'm schooling in is not like native to our culture and our people, literally. And then I didn't know back then that it was burnt bricks and columns. So when I graduated from King's College, a year after, I started documenting these buildings. I was taking pictures of them with my friend who lived around the area. But at that point, I had not started like researching on the buildings and all that. But prior 2016, that was when I started documenting. I was researching. I did a lot of research on these buildings and then the architectural styles, the materials employed in the construction process, and all of that, basically. So I would say between 2014 and 2016 was like a starting process, which I actually didn't even know was going to turn out to be this.
Wow. So what have you observed so far in Lagos? Do we have lots of these buildings? I feel like there are certain neighborhoods where these buildings are prominent, like Lagos Island, which is where King's College is. Yeah. Exactly. So they're like prominent in neighborhoods like that. But across the state, would you say there are actually still colonial buildings standing?
Well, between 2016 and 2018, I've traveled to like some cities in Nigeria. Basically, I've been to Calabar, I've been to Abeokuta, and so many others. And I would literally say that there are literally more colonial buildings in these other cities over Lagos, because, like I said, most of the buildings in Lagos are being demolished, and that's currently, as it stands, they have so many buildings in like these cities compared to like Lagos.
Well, this is such a beautiful building. What building is this?
This is the old government house. And then in 1956, there was a state garden party that was held here for Queen Elizabeth II when she was in Lagos. And it's constructed in a British colonial architecture, and somebody tagged it a cake kind of architecture.
Cake?
Yes.
Did you say cake?
Yes, cake.
I can see it. I can see it because of the color and even the shape. It looks like a wedding cake.
Yes, yes.
So what did you... So have you been to this building and...
Yes, I was the one that took the picture.
No, have you gone for any... Is it still being used for anything
Now? The first time I took a picture of the building, it was still under the federal government, the authority of the federal government. Ownership was still under the federal government. But as of now, the ownership is under the state government. And literally in the news, they have plans of converting it to a museum, basically. And then but one of the things I would like to note is that in trying to preserve these buildings, we're not used to like the crafts, because like most of the people that are used to like construct these buildings, they're literally gone, and then their children didn't take up the craft unlike in so many other cities, basically. And in trying to preserve them, they would only renovate, which shouldn't be done to these buildings. Rather, they should literally restore these buildings, because this building used to have a wooden windows and all, but as you can see from like 1960s, 70s, it was changed. So basically, I think they should just like sort of like preserve it in like its original pristine form. But I think the last time sort of like event was held, literally, I think it was a state party. I think that was in the 1980s or thereabouts, yeah. Basically.
But my issue with preserving these places is the materials.
Yeah.
You know, the materials they used then, we don't have them now.
Yes.
These are like major old wood.
Yes.
You know, like, yeah, you know what I'm talking about. So how can we preserve them even when we don't have those materials present now? And because we don't have those materials present now, we may not have people who understand
the
materials that were used for these buildings. So how do we preserve them?
I'm always on Twitter. I'm always like preferring solutions, even if it's for free, basically, because like I'm really interested in like seeing these buildings look like as when they were constructed, basically. And I feel, like I said not too long ago, these buildings were literally, the people that constructed them, their children didn't take up the craft unlike so many other cities.
Oh,
and
wow.
I think what we need to do, and some people have also preferred the solution, is to invite experts from either Salvador, from Europe, or thereabouts, and then they could train some Nigerians are interested in the conservation and preservation process and all
craft.
That, and in the craft, so that at least from then on, we could also have like a little academy or thereabouts or center that can keep on after they've done the first process, can now take it up, like next set of generations can take it up and then learn and also preserve these buildings. And I think, but for now, if we don't have the materials, then what we need to do is we just have to just import them. And I know that it's going to be very expensive, but it's a very old building. You can't even find like a material.
They're like national treasures. And I know this is the Duro Jaye Manor House, right?
Yes, yes.
So does the family still live here? Because it's almost like a national treasure.
Yes.
Even though it's been modernized a bit. I mean, we see the dish by the side. I'm sure. I'm sure when it was constructed, they were not watching satellite TV,
but now
they can watch Arise, you know? So tell me about this house. What drew you, what attracted you to this house?
I was walking past Lagos. I was walking around the Oshodi Street. There's a particular house which is called the, it's constructed in 1920s, Adegbibe Villa, and then it was constructed in 1920s. And I was just walking past, I had taken pictures of this building, and then on the next corner of the street, I found this house, and I was with a friend of mine who was my senior in secondary school.
Right.
So literally, sometimes we just walk around, and then he would literally go with me, and then we'd take pictures of these buildings. And then I found this building, and that was last year, just I think that makes it a year, May of last year, basically. And then I just took pictures of the building. I had not yet entered inside or like felt, oh, there was something like really interesting about the building.
Yeah.
I only took pictures of it, and then it was up until this year. And when I went to, I got there, I was with someone else, and then I said, okay, let me just knock on the door.
And see if they'll let me in.
Yeah.
And they let you in?
Funny enough,
amazing.
Yeah, they let me in. And then the first thing that caught my eye, there was a picture of the Tinubu Square in the 50s, just right when you enter, just by the wall.
Yeah, you know, I've seen some pictures like that with my grandfather's house of like Lagos Island in the 50s and in the 40s, Broad Street, the whole of Marina.
Definitely.
Beautiful, not congested. It's so different now. And actually, it just occurred to me that maybe we should be getting the government involved, and not just the government, but also the private sector, because houses like this are being used for movies.
Yes,
so this is the kind of house that they'll use for like a spooky horror movie, but we're not really utilizing these houses here. But talk to me about your relationship with the government. I know there's a government agency in charge of museums and monuments. Have you been in touch with them? How is the relationship? Are you begging them not to tear down this building?
The NCMM, the National Commission for Museums and Monuments, their last law was, I think, 1999, thereabouts. And then in their law, literally, because like even in countries like the UK and the United States, basically, there are laws which back these buildings. And then the law from 1999 states that anyone that pulls down a colonial or a national monument, listed site, property, or whatever, will have to pay a fine of 500 naira.
Five what?
Yes, and then
500
the maximum
naira.
Is 1,000 naira, yes.
So I can tear down a colonial building.
Yes.
And I'll be charged 500 naira.
Literally.
That is not good enough.
You literally won't even be charged, because I mean, like, why would somebody even charge you 1,000 naira for even like tearing down your building? So like literally like the law hasn't been updated, but the Lagos State Government law, which was last updated in 2011 under the Fashola government, states that anyone that alters any part, even if it's like the window or the door, would have to pay a fine of 500,000 naira.
Okay,
and
great.
Then
that's
if
like
you
it.
Pull down a colonial structure or a listed site, the person will have to like pay a fine of 1 million naira basically.
Okay.
But we can see that the laws are not literally being executed and enforced properly, because there's a particular building in Lagos Island which used to be on the corner of Tinubu Square, and that was a Brazilian building that was literally famous in Brazilian, Afro-Brazilian architecture basically. And
don't tell me it was pulled down.
It was pulled down in 2016.
No.
Yes, and then I work as a tour guide for Legacy 1995 Nigeria, and literally there were plans that would have been made even with the Afro-Brazilian Descendant Union to like restore the building. But we know how it is with the government in Nigeria. Things take time, processes,
red tape, all of that.
Basically, so it was pulled down, and then. Literally, it was a sad situation.
Wow, yes, they really, really need to be preserving these buildings. Who is this? Is this the house? This is the Durosimi?
No, I took this. This is in Ilesha.
So beautiful.
And then the interesting thing I found out about this building is the fact that I didn't find out the year it was built, basically, but I think there was a particular king of Ilesha from like the 1890s who constructed this building, basically, and then his son's wife is the one that is in the picture there.
Oh, bless.
I think she's in her 90s, but she's still living there.
Yes. So these are picturesque. You know, all you Instagram bloggers, these are places to go to take your slay photos, you know. These are like beautiful backdrops. These are like sources of revenue for even for the states. You know, this is Malaysia and Ocean State. The ones in Lagos State as well, the government really needs to be on top of it. And I think you're doing a brilliant job. Thank you for preserving our culture. You know,
Thank you.
At this and we know where we are coming from.
Yes.
We know, okay, we're ruled by colonial masters and all of that, but it just reminds us of where we're coming from, and that would help. Thank you so much.
I really appreciate it.
How can people reach you on social media?
My Instagram handle is The Facade Nigeria, and then...
The Facade?
Yeah, The
Nigeria.
Facade Nigeria.
Okay.
Basically because of, like, the front part of, like, every colonial structure.
Right.
And then my Twitter is at Kelechi Naba, which Kelechi, N-A-B-A, no space, basically.
On Twitter. And you're very responsive, like
you said. Yeah, so you'll find me ranting about colonial structures.
Ranting about colonial structures. Yeah. It's been amazing talking to you, Kelechi.
Thank you very
much. Please come again.
Thank you.
Okay, and that's all from Kelechi, the Bodden preservationist. Taiwo Ketiku, also known as Food in Lagos, will be sitting here with me after the break. Don't go away.
In a fast